One of the most striking and obvious differences between the Bible and the secular outlook today concerns the Earth's physical history. Exodus 20:11, in the context of the Ten Commandments, declares that in 6 days God created the heavens and the earth, the sea, and all that is within them. Indeed, given the astonishing complexity of living organisms revealed by molecular biology over the past 70 years, the only rational way organisms, even as simple as bacteria, could possibly have come into existence is by nearly instantaneous supernatural creation. But the Bible indicates that the earth itself, the stars, and the galaxies did as well, and only a few thousand years ago. The secular view, which of course steadfastly excludes God, insists that matter, energy, as well as stars, galaxies, and planets, including the earth, came into existence on their own over immense spans of time, guided only by the laws of nature. As to the source for the laws of nature, secularists have no explanation. The biblical view and the secular view on the origin of the cosmos and earth are therefore radically at odds with each other. Obviously, these two accounts in regard to earth history are radically different. Is there any decisive way by examining the physical evidence to identify which of these accounts actually conforms with reality? My conviction is that there is. I conclude that abundant physical indicators documenting a recent global flood cataclysm overwhelmingly favor the biblical account of Earth history. These physical indicators fall into four main categories. First is that of fossils. To be fossilized, an organism needs to be buried rapidly and completely. Otherwise, the organism's remains disappear quickly through the agency of scavengers and bacterial decomposition. Fossils are therefore a reliable indicator of catastrophic conditions. Beginning from the first occurrence of multicellular organisms in the rock record all the way to near to the top of the record, well-preserved fossils are so common that the inference that this entire record is the product of catastrophic conditions is not merely reasonable, but nigh to certain. The second category of evidence involves the sedimentary layers themselves. Sedimentary rocks are composed of water-suspended, water-transported sediment particles. Generally speaking, turbulence is the mechanism by which sediment particles are maintained in suspension in moving water. And the higher the water speed, the stronger the turbulence. The fact that sediment layers are frequently uniform over tens and hundreds of miles in both horizontal directions speaks of extreme current velocities over vast areas. In other words, catastrophic water flow environments. The third category of evidence are indicators that the fossil-bearing sediment record spans only a few thousand years in time, not hundreds of millions. Probably the simplest line of such evidence are the examples of well-preserved soft tissue and fossils of a variety of organisms throughout the record. One example, just one example, is flexible blood vessels still containing red blood cells recovered from a femur of a T-Rex dinosaur and reported in the journal Science in 2005. The fourth category concerns the evidence that vast large-scale tectonic changes occurred rapidly since the point that animal fossils first appear in the rock record. Younger ages for the basalt forming today's ocean crust relative to the age of these fossils implies that all of today's ocean crust has formed since the onset of the flood cataclysm. This implies that the flood was not merely a water cataclysm, but also a tectonic cataclysm, which recycled all the pre-flood ocean floor into the Earth's interior within only a few months' time. This conclusion, first presented in the mid-1980s, is now known as catastrophic plate tectonics. This presentation will deal with additional evidence for the reality of catastrophic plate tectonics, the physical mechanisms responsible for its occurrence, and how, Through the tsunamis it generated, it produced the thousands of feet of fossil-bearing sediments that now blanket the continents. I hope you will tune in to the presentation live on June 14th. Thank you.